Hi, have you ever wanted to create your own custom Google map, or better yet, have your students create their own custom maps? Well, today I'm going to show you how to easily do this in Google. First of all, you need to be signed into your Google account and then select Google Maps. Once you get into Google Maps, you want to select My Places. Once you select My Places, you'll see some maps if you've already created some in the past, but today we're going to start with a new map, so I want to click on Create Map. The first thing you want to do is you want to name your map. So let's say I'm going to create a map about Missouri Civil War battlefields. So I've named my map Missouri Civil War Battles. I could add a more detailed description down below, but at this point I won't. You can come back and do that later. But now I need to decide if I want to make my map public, where anybody can see it, or if I want it to be unlisted. If I select unlisted, only people that have the link that I would send out would be able to access the map. So once you're done naming your map and deciding your privacy settings, you're going to select Done, and your map is now created, but you don't have anything on your map yet. So now I want to select the red button that says Edit. Now up on top, I'm going to type in the name of one of the battlefields here in Missouri, Wilson's Creek. And as I start to type it, Google identifies that it is in Brookline, so I'm going to click on that. And on my Google map, I'll see that it says Wilson's Creek National Battlefield, and there's even a visitor center there. So that's where I want to place my push pin, where I want to identify on the map where the Battle of Wilson's Creek took place. So I'm going to go up here to the top, and there's a button, or it looks like a little place mark, that says Add a Place Mark. I'm going to select that, and once I click on that, it's going to allow me to move around, and I can hover over any location on the map. Once I click, it's going to place that push pin in the map. So now I want to name that push pin. So since it's on Wilson's Creek Battlefield, I'm going to name it Wilson's Creek Battle. Okay. Now you can add more things to this, and I'll talk about that in a further tutorial. But at this point, I want to click OK. And I've now named a push pin that is in my map. So if I look down below my map, it's going to say Wilson's Creek Battle. And that's where I have one push pin now in my Missouri Civil War Battles map. Now, obviously, you're going to want to add more and more things to this, and you can always come back and add things later. But at this point, I'm going to click Done, and my map is now done with one pushpin in it. On top, you're going to see a link up here. If you click on Link, you're going to be able to have a link that you can then save and send to somebody in an email. You could put it as a link on a web page. And then as you further develop your page, you could also embed it into a website or a blog. So pretty easy to do. I've done this with my students in class. They've enjoyed doing this before, and it's a lot of fun. You can also click on Collaborate above your map. And at this point, you could have specific people working on one map. So maybe you have five students that you want to work on one map, and you maybe have another group of students that are going to work on a completely different map. As long as you have their email addresses, you can send them an invite and tell them that they're people that are working on that map together. Now, I could also decide to allow anybody to edit this map if I select this button, and that means anybody that has access to that map or that link could add places to it, or I could also say that anybody that's collaborating could invite others to collaborate with them. At this point, I won't select either one of those. So, it's that easy. Creating a customized Google map, students have a lot of fun placing push pins in the places that they need to remember, and it's been my experience in the past that students are much better about remembering these locations and knowing where they're at if they're able to make their own map. So, go out and make your own customized Google map.